channel, Clinical Biochemistry by Dr. P.K. Prabhakar. Last week, we have seen the different steps of glycolysis, how glycolysis occurs. So we have seen there are 10 steps in the glycolysis, and 10 steps was catalyzed by 10 different enzymes. Out of those 10 steps, 3 steps was irreversible reaction, and the 7 reactions was reversible reactions. Out of those 10 step reactions, there are 5 steps where involvement of either ATP was there, either ATP was utilized or ATP was produced, or NADP was there, NADH was there. So we'll see those 5 steps reactions. Those steps was, the first step of the reaction is where ATP was involved was where glucose converted to glucose 6-phosphate, and their involvement of ATP was there, and as a result we got ADP. This was the involvement of ATP. Second step of reaction was there where fructose 6-phosphate converted to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. There also ATP was used and ADP was produced. This was third reaction of the reaction. And another reaction, third step where involvement of any of the molecule is there, where glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate was converted to 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. There we have used an AD plus and we got an ADH. Fourth step of reaction is where ATP is produced or ATP was utilized was 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. I removed one of the phosphate from this bisphosphoglycerate and it was converted to 3-phosphoglycerate. There ADP was used and ATP was produced. And the fifth reaction where ATP or ADP or any kind of molecule is involved, that was phosphoenol pyruvate converted to pyruvic acid. There also ADP was involved, ATP was produced. So these are the 5 out of those 10 step reactions, 5 steps are there where either ATP, ADP or NAD plus was involved. So these 5 step reaction is normally responsible for the energetics of glycolysis. So we are going to see today energetics of glycolysis. How much ATP we are going to get from the ATP, glycolysis, and how we are going to get it. Now, we have in our glycolysis, we have used one molecule of glucose converted to one molecule of glucose 6-phosphate. So as a result, we have utilized one ATP. So that's why I put minus symbol there. So one molecule of glucose in the another reactions. This is again one molecule of fructose 6-phosphate converted to one molecule of fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. So only one ATP was involved, utilized here also. So that was minus 1 ATP. This 1,6-fructose 1,6-bisphosphate was divided into two molecules. One was glycerol 3-phosphate, other one was dihydroxyacetone phosphate by the reaction catalyzed by LOH. So ultimately in glycolysis we have got two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So one molecule utilizes one molecule of NADH D plus, but two molecules will use two molecule of NAD plus, and we will get two molecule of NADH. and ultimately two molecule of 1,3 bisphosphoglycerol will be produced. So we have got two molecule of NADH. So two molecule of 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate converted to two molecule of 3 phosphoglycerate to utilize two molecule of ATP converted into gives you two molecule of ATP. So ultimate gain was plus 2 ATP. This in the last 10th step, two molecule of phosphoenol pyruvate converted to two molecule of pyruvic acid, and you just two molecule of ATP converted to two molecule of ATP. So ultimate gain was plus 2 ATP. Now if you say overall what we have got it, this we have got two molecule of ATP and two molecule of ATP, so total 4 ATP we have gained, 2 ATP we have utilized, so minus 2 ATP, and we have got 2 molecule of NADH. So this is equal to 4 molecule we have got it, 2 molecule we have utilized, so overall gain was 2 molecule of ATP and 2 molecule of NADH. So this is our final gain from the glycolysis. Now this NADH will go to mitochondria and gives us ATP through the oxidative phosphorylation. This NADH, how much ATP it will give, it depends on processes. The process is, it is going to use two different shuttle system. Just one second. This is our cell. In our cell, glycolysis occurs in cytoplasm. We have nucleus. This is our mitochondria. So in the cytoplasm we have produced 2 ATP plus 2 NADH. This NADH will give us energy ATP once for that one it has to go to mitochondria. And there we are having electron transport chain. That electron transport chain, there oxidative phosphorylation will take place and we will get ATP. So this gives us ATP. That depends on by which process it is going reaching to the mitochondria. So for that one we are having two shuttle system. One of the shuttle system is called as glycerol phosphate shuttle, and second one is called as aspartate malate shuttle system. So these are the two shuttle system which is normally present in our cells, where by which NADH which is produced in the cytoplasm will reach to the mitochondria. This malate aspartate shuttle system, your aspartate malate shuttle system, normally present mainly in liver, it present in kidney, it present in cardiac tissue or heart tissue, and this mainly present in skeletal muscle, adipose tissue and brain. So we are having two shuttle system by which it NADH produced in the glycolysis will reach to the mitochondria. Either it will be glycerol phosphate shuttle system or it will be aspartate malate aspartate shuttle system or aspartate malate system shuttle system. Glycerol phosphate shuttle system is present in skeletal tissue muscles, adipose tissue or brain. Aspartate malate shuttle system is mainly present in liver, kidney and cardiac tissue. Now we will see the shuttle system one by one. So first we are going to see aspartate malate shuttle system, how it works. In the glycolysis, we have used glucose, and through process, in the process we have produced, we have used NAD plus, we have got NADH. This NADH has to cross, this is our mitochondrial membrane. So this NADH has to go to mitochondria. So this NADH you will be used by, first we are having an enzyme that is called malate dehydrogenate. This enzyme is having two isoenzymes, one is cytosolic, second one is mitochondrial. So in this is our cytoplasm and this is mitochondrial matrix. So in the cytoplasm, first oxaloacetate will be converted to malate with the utilization of NADH converted to NAD plus. This malate will be transported to mitochondria through a transporter. Along with that one, oxaloacetate is alpha ketoglutarate is also transported. So this malate will be transferred to the mitochondria. Now this reaction is catalyzed by malate dehydrogenate, but it is cytosolic, so that's why I put C as a substrate. In the mitochondria, this malate will be converted back to oxaloacetate, and it releases, it uses an AD plus, return into an ADH, an enzyme is malate dehydrogenase, but it will be mitochondrial. Fine. This oxaloacetate is converted into aspartate by the enzyme AST. This aspartate can cross this mitochondrial membrane and come into the cytoplasm. So aspartate, and in the cytoplasm aspartate will be converted into by same AST enzyme into oxaloacetate. So this is a cyclic process where aspartate and malate is crossing the mitochondrial membrane, and in return it's carrying this electron and proton which this NADH is having to the mitochondria. So we are using cytoplasmic NADH here, and in return we are getting same NADH. So there is no loss of any kind of equivalent. This is one shuttle system. This is called as our malate aspartate shuttle system. We are having another shuttle system that is called as glycerol-phosphate shuttle system. In this glycerol-phosphate shuttle system, we are having this NADPH will be used by dihydroxyacetone phosphate. It converted into glycerol 3-phosphate. It utilized here and converted into NAD+. This glycerol-3-phosphate can transport it into the mitochondria by a transporter. So we have glycerol-3-phosphate into the mitochondria. And in return, this will be converted back to dihydroxyacetone phosphate. But once this is going to convert it to dihydroxyacetone phosphate, in return, it is not utilizing NADH, it is utilizing FAD plus and gives us FADH. So the difference between malate aspartate and glycerol phosphate shuttle is, in case of malate aspartate, we have used cytoplasmic NADH. Inside mitochondria, we have got same NADH. But in case of glycerol phosphate shuttle system, we are going to use cytoplasmic NADH, but in return, we are getting FAD. So there is a loss in energy. Now, if we are having NADH in oxidative phosphorylation, we are going to get 380. But if we are going to use FADH, we are going to get only 280. So here is the difference. Now remember, at the end of glycolysis, we have got our gain was 2 ATP and we have got 2 NADH. If we are going to use malate aspartate shuttle, in that case, this 2 will give 2 ATP. This through malate aspartate system, in place of NADH, we are getting NADH only, so we are going to get 2 multiplied by 3 ATP. So ultimately, we are going to get 6 ATP. But if we are going to get glycerol phosphate shuttle system, then here we will get 2 ATP, but here we will get, in return, we will use NADH and we will get FADH. So we will get only 2 multiplied by 2 ATP. So total 4 ATP. So at the end of glycolysis, either we are going to get 8 ATP or 6 ATP. That depends on which type of shuttle system has been utilized for the transportation of NADH from the cytoplasm to mitochondria. If we are going to use malate aspartate shuttle system, we will get 8 ATP. If we are going to get glycerol phosphate shuttle system, we will get 6 ATP. All these process, if the process is in presence of oxygen, if this glycolysis occurs in anaerobic conditions, then we are not going to get any NADH. Our ultimate gain will be through the glycolysis in case of anaerobic condition is only 2 ATP. So we are not, in case of anaerobic condition, we are not going to get any kind of NADH. So there is no question of 6 ATP or 4 ATP. So our ultimate gain only will be 2 ATP in case of anaerobic conditions. So hope you have understand how what is the ultimate gain, what is the energetics of glycolysis, how much many ATP we are going to get, and why there is a difference through the different shuttle system and what is the shuttle system. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe it. If you like the video, please share it, and thank you very much.